The Bible says that anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. All things pass away. Behold, all things become new. He wants to bring you into a newness of life. He wants you to open up your life to reality. He wants to pour His Spirit into your life and pour His love into your life. But you got to be willing to come to Him. Oh, He's such a good God. And if you surrender to Jesus Christ, and once you taste that the Lord is good, you will want more and more and more. But you got to be willing to take a step of faith. You got to be willing to submit and surrender. If not, you are going to stand before the judgment seat of God. And He is going to judge you. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day of mercy. The mercy seat is on this side of heaven, not on that side. Once you get on that side, what's done is done. The choices you made will have an effect for all of eternity. You must choose this day who you will serve. Will you choose God? Or will you go on rejecting God? Because we got a lot of God rejectors in this world. We live in a God rejecting world that don't care nothing about God. They give no thought about eternity. They give no thought about standing before God and answering to God. You are going to answer to Jesus Christ. Each and every person on the face of this planet is going to stand before God. And they are going to give an account. But God desires to save you. The Bible says He's long-suffering, not willing that no one should perish, but that all should come to repentance. God desires you to repent. And repent means have a change of heart. Have a change of direction in the life that you live and realize that God is a reality. And He is the greatest reality in this little world. And turn to Him with all your heart. Submit yourself to God. And the Bible says anybody who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. He will bring deliverance. He has delivering power. For He set me free from heroin addiction, alcohol addiction. He set me free from pornography. He set me free from fornication. He empowered me with His Spirit to be a witness. God will pour His Spirit into your life. He will sanctify your heart. God has a desire to sanctify your heart. He has a desire to recondition the condition of your heart. And your heart's in sin. And God longs for you to come to Him today. But you have to make that decision. You have to make that choice. You have to open up your eyes and realize that you're going to stand before God and you're going to answer to Him on judgment. Each and every person. It don't matter where you're from. It don't matter who you are. The old, the young, the rich and the poor, they're all going to stand before God and they're going to give an account for their lives. And without redemption, without salvation through Jesus Christ, they are going to spend an eternity in hell. Whether they believe it or not, whether you say there's no God or whether you say there is a God, you are going to stand before the God that created you. Are you ready to meet your God? Are you prepared to meet the one who created you? Are you ready to stand before a holy God and give an account for your life? Or are you rejecting God? Are you living godless lifestyles and living like God does not exist? Because there is a place specifically designed for people who don't want nothing to do with God. And if you don't want nothing to do with God on this side of eternity, there is a place specifically designed for people who don't want nothing to do with Jesus Christ, and it is called hellfire. It is a place of punishment, a place of torment. It's a place where all God rejecters will spend an eternity there. There's no parties in hell. There's no fun in hell. There's no forgiveness in hell. But God desires to save you from the torments of hell. But you got to be willing to come to Him. You got to be willing to repent. It's up to you. God extends his hand of mercy. He extends his love to you through his son, Jesus Christ. But you got to be willing to recognize this. You got to be willing to come to him and bow your knee to the Lordship of Jesus Christ and be born again by the Spirit of the living God. God wants to sanctify your heart. God wants to deliver you from that bondage that you're in. Some of you are hurt out there. You're broken. You're full of hatred in your heart. You wonder why your families are unstable. You wonder why relationships are falling apart. Come to the Lord. The Bible says that he came to heal the brokenhearted and set the captives free. See, humanity is broken because of sin. They're brokenhearted because sin has destroyed their lives. They are alienated from a relationship with God because of sin. And the majority of them refuse to come to God. So their life is destroyed. But Jesus Christ wants to heal you today. Jesus Christ wants to deliver you today. But you got to be willing to come to him. You got to be willing to repent. The Bible says that we ought to produce fruit in keeping with repentance. For the ox is at the root of the tree, and any tree that does not produce fruit is going to get chopped down. You are going to stand at the judgment seat. And I'm going to talk about the judgment seat a lot because I want you to recognize this reality in your life. That you are going to stand before him. You're going to answer for God. Each and every one of you is going to stand before Jesus Christ. And you're going to answer to him. And if you have not received forgiveness for your sins, you are going to spend an eternity in hell. It doesn't make no difference if you believe in hell. It doesn't make no difference if you say, oh, there is no hell. It does not change the fact that the Bible says without repentance, you are going to spend an eternity in hell. You are going to stand before the God on judgment day. And you're going to hear the words, depart from me. You who practice iniquity. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Hold on, let me restart this video.